probably heard the voice of our next guest on the radio for 20 years. He's been here on KFI for the last 10.
My favorite of all time at KFI, Tim Conway Jr. Ding dong.
Thank you. Ding dong with
here
you guys.
In the house.
I love the show. I watch it. I was watching it the other day.
Thank you.
When you had the bailiff on from Judge Judy.
Yeah, Petrie Bird.
Yeah, man, that guy's great.
He was great. We had a lot of fun with him.
Yeah.
Just like, you know, you've been around a long, long time.
23 years.
Hard to believe, huh? Wow.
I know. It does seem like 23 years, 23 minutes.
Yeah, right.
But here's the thing. You avoid the evening rush because you're working.
That's right. I have to be to work at 6 o'clock. I live a mile from the station. So when John and Ken sign off, I get in the car. And I'm there before the show starts.
That's awesome.
Mind blowing.
Right.
Everybody in L.A. hates you because of that.
But you tell that to people in Valencia who work in Torrance, and they absolutely hate you for it.
Absolutely. Yes. I want to know, do you like to make dinner reservations? I always wonder that from radio people, because they already know your voice, and you're like, hi, it's Tim Conway Jr. I'd like to make a dinner reservation.
Okay.
Well, do you know what I'm saying?
Here's a great story. I'm down in Seal Beach, and they have Walt's Wharf, which is one of the great restaurants in Seal Beach, in all of Orange County, if not, California. And there's a guy named John, who's the maitre d'. He's been there forever, right? And I walk into Walt's Wharf, and I said, hey, can I make a reservation? He says, yeah, we're about an hour out. And I said, okay, can I put my name down? He goes, I think I already know your name. Is it Conway? You work at KFI? I said, yeah.
Exactly, my point.
And we were talking for like 5 minutes. There was nobody else coming. And he wrote my name down. And I said, he goes, I'm going to do you a solid because you work for KFI. I'm like, hey, I get the next table, right?
What?
He goes, I'm going to page you personally an hour.
I'm going to say, Tim Conway Jr., your table is ready.
Exactly.
In 1 hour, so 1 hour later, he calls me. I'm home cooking a burger at the time.
What the heck are you going to do in Seal Beach for an hour, though?
Right, that's exactly
right. That's really the question.
It is beautiful. You run to Seal Beach?
Yeah, of course. We drive by there all the time. But
the mayor of Seal Beach called me and said, please stop talking about how great this city is. It brings in the riffraff.
Yeah, right.
True
story. One of the funniest things, because I know you love the valley, that you said the other day when I was listening, was that Burbank should have its own football team.
That's right.
I mean, it's
right.
The valley's bigger than Green Bay.
Yeah. Well, yeah, there's 105,000 people live in Green Bay, about 105,000 live in Burbank, and yet we have nothing. The valley has
nothing.
The valley has no museums, no sports teams. There's too many people live in the valley, right? If it was its own city, it'd be the seventh largest city in the United States.
Hard to believe.
No football, no track, no theater, no golf course, no five-star restaurant, nothing.
But ask KFI.
You put in, when you come into town on your GPS, you put in tourist attraction in the valley, and the first thing that pops up is Universal, second is Disneyland, then Knott's Berry Farm. None of it's in the valley.
None of it's in the valley.
They get screwed. They really do.
They really do.
Every single time.
Tell me about how to sustain a radio career over time. Like, how do you keep up with things? How do you keep, I mean, I guess it's kind of the same thing that we're doing on the daily, but.
Right. Well, I've been suspended and fired. I mean, it's not I know all the secrets.
We've all been there.
I don't think, if you've not been fired or suspended, I don't think you're pushing hard enough. You know what I mean?
I agree.
Like, you guys will be fired from this thing eventually.
Eventually, somebody will push us out.
Somebody will come in and you guys will be gone. But until then, KDOC.
Right, here we are.
But you guys expanded to an hour, right?
We did. Yeah,
congratulations.
Yeah. Yes, thank
really
you.
Cool. I mean, we used to do this for 5 hours when we were in San Diego.
Oh, okay.
So it was like radio.
Oh, you knock it out there.
Yeah, so now, this is easy. An hour is no problem.
So listen, we recently lost your dad, and I was very sad about that. He was one of my favorite people in all the world.
Oh, that's very nice.
And I know he meant an awful lot to you, and you have a lot of the same lovable qualities of your pop.
Well, that's very nice of you to say. It was difficult for the grandchildren, you know, for the kids. My dad was awfully sick for the last 4 or 5 years, and people would call the station and say, why don't you have your dad on? And I always made up excuses like, you know, we called his manager, but his manager hasn't called us back, but I'm sure tomorrow he'll email us or whatever.
Right.
But there was I was at the racetrack over the weekend, odd as it might seem.
Well, they had the big race
there.
That's right, Breeders' Cup. Going with the Breeders' Cup.
Sure.
And a guy came up to me, he's about 82 years old, and I've known him forever. I've known him since I was like 5 or 6 when I first went to the track.
Is he your bookie?
Not the bookie. But
that's
he knows somebody can cash a ticket in and save you some taxes.
Right.
So he's about 82, and he comes up and he says, hey, he says, I'm sorry to hear about your dad. And I go, what? What'd you hear? And he's like, oh, no, you didn't know? he thought he was telling me for the first time.
Oh, no.
That's so funny.
Virtually gave the guy a heart attack.
Oh, jeez. so bad.
It was horrible.
Yeah, that is so terrible. Bad.
But you know, it's not like he's gone, though, because if you watch TV,
he's on.
Mikhail's Navy comes on. I mean, can you imagine, you know, obviously you guys, I think your dad is still with us, and yours, obviously. But if you're watching, you know, when your dad moves on or somebody, you know, that you love moved on, and yet you watch TV and they come on TV,
it's amazing.
It's almost as if they're still in the room.
It's an amazing thing. You know?
It really is cool.
Yeah. So here's the thing. I love listening to you on the radio. It's really a joyous, fun
Thank
time.
You,
I mean, it's raucous.
And need I love more of you.
I love when, you know, Jay Leno pops up and says, I got to be on the Conway show. I mean, that's got to be cool that people like that are listening to
you. Well, you know, I think he comes on because I do a really bad Jay Leno impression.
Oh, yeah, baby.
You know, you do? Can you do it? I love that
impression. I don't know if I can
impression.
Do it here, but...
I can. I can do it.
He's like,
yeah.
So, yeah, you like a thing, five for fighting. I'm so tired of seeing all these...
I like five for fighting.
Yeah, but, see? I like it.
So he
That's
calls...
A bad impression.
Horrible impression. But he calls to get me to stop doing it, right? He's like, hey, listen,
hey,
if I call
it.
You every once in a while, would you stop doing that? And I said, yeah, you got it. And then he calls, and then I do it as soon as he's off the phone. And I think it irritates him. He hasn't called me in a while.
Well, Tim, thank you for stopping by.
I love this.
Thank you.
This is the greatest show ever.
We appreciate that.
It is so much better than those other horrible shows that are on in the morning.
That
don't book me, by the way.
I agree.
They don't book you.
Yes, exactly.
No, we love you.
How dare they?
Yeah, we love you.
We're going to trash them tonight on KFI.
Absolutely.
Exactly.
Listen.
And when I need a dinner reservation, I'm going to have you call for me.
Ding dong.
There you go.
Let's
Tim Conway Jr., 6 to 10 every day on
Thank
KFI.
You. Thank you so much.
Love having you here.